Hi, I'm Ellie Downie and this is my gymnastics scrapbook. Right then, let's have a look at the first photo. I think I was about level 3, so 9 maybe. I was actually a terrible dancer. It's just so cute and cringy. So this was UK School Games 2012. I remember this was the phase when I asked my mum if I could cut my hair short, dye it red. For some reason, she let me. So this was 2015 Europeans, my first senior Euros. I remember getting past bars and beam, and it was definitely like, oh, sigh of relief, I've just got floor and vault left, which are normally in comp pretty solid. Looked at the scoreboard and I was third, which is another huge surprise. Was not expecting it from like a first senior European, so. Becky with a big mouth. Oh. So this is 2015 Worlds. I remember someone saying before vault, if we all nail our vaults, we could actually come third. And I was like, there's no chance, we're nowhere near. So Frags was first, nailed hers. Amy's was first. She probably did the best double twist that she could have ever done. And then I went, and then I remember Liz just ran up to me and hugged me really tight. And I was like, why is she hugging me so much? And then she was like, look, look, look. And I was like, oh my gosh. So yeah, that was probably one of the most crazy competition I've ever done. I love this picture. Rio was a very mixed experience for me, obviously. I remember walking into the arena and I literally said to the girls, I've never felt more calm to compete. And then I remember starting on floor, did a really good floor. Then I went to vault and stuck it dead after I'd already stuck it dead in the team final, which was really cool. And then bars just went, never done a bar routine that bad. And then I was out on beam. I was like, I've got nothing to lose now. So I tried my big dismount off beam and then put my hands down. So I'd had 3 falls. I was devastated. But I remember going up before this piece. I was standing there for like 10 minutes because Simone was on the floor in the background and I was like, everyone's just waiting for her. So yeah, my face in this picture's like, hurry up and just let me get on the beam. Yeah, so this vault was 2017 British. Quite a lucky stick, I think. Was surprised when I did it. This meant a lot to me because Rio wasn't the best. And I took time off after Rio and I came back and was like, I'm just going to work. And I want to prove to people that in Rio, it wasn't my best performance. And I know it wasn't. So it was kind of like redemption, I guess. Yeah, I like this picture. This was 2017 Europeans. Going into it, I had zero expectations because the British, I injured my ankle and I was in a boot for 2 weeks. It was my call if I wanted to try and do the Euros or not. And I was like, I've got myself so fit and worked so hard, it'd be such a waste not to. And that was my decision and definitely the best decision I've made. And then it was just like piece after piece. I was just shocked by how well I was doing. And then I got to beam and I was like, I was pretty nervous and it was a bit shaky for me and wasn't my best score. But then I felt like I'd still done enough that if I did a good floor, I'd be fine. But then on my second tumble on floor, I ran backwards and I was like, oh, I think I've blown it now. But then just when that score came up, I was emotional. You're gonna make me cry. God, let me chill. Yeah, so this one was obviously another disappointment. After 2017 Euros, I had my first ankle surgery. And it was kind of just, I had scar tissue around and needed like two tiny bones removed just so my ankle would move better. At the time, it's really disheartening and disappointing because I was literally, I'd say, at the peak of my career, and then to be injured for that long, I did not expect it at all. I thought it'd be 3 to 6 months, if anything, but then a year and a half later, it turned out to be before I was back on an international stage. So yeah, that was hard. At the minute, training is going really, really well, touch wood. I'm really excited for this year. I've been working hard. I think after Worlds last year, it was kind of, I just got back out there for myself with no expectations, and I was really pleased with what I did. So I've just been building from there, and I'm really happy with training. I've got some upgrades. And yeah, I think hopefully it's going to be an exciting year. So I'm excited. Hi guys, it's a few months later and I wanted to update my scrapbook. So let's see what I've been up to. So obviously the British Championships this year was a really good one for me. Going into it, training had been really good. Probably not on bars actually, training a bit up and down on bars, and that was the piece I was starting on. So to get through that bar routine to start was really, really good and just kind of set me off for the whole competition really. And it was just so good to be back out there doing all four pieces again at the level that I know I'm capable of. And then just when I nailed that vault at the end, it was just a huge relief and I was just so happy. So this is the moment I realised that I'd won. One of my teammates, Lottie, she was going round at the same time, but we were just in different groups. So I kind of ran over to her at the end and just gave her a huge hug. And she knows how hard I've been working for the past year. So it was a really nice moment to have with her and especially my coach. So the European Championships this year, I was pretty confident going into it, but at the same time, I knew I had quite a lot of expectation on me going in as the reigning all-around champion. I had actually had to change my bar routine just a couple of days before because my new element wasn't working. So we had to put back in the old forward skill. But luckily it paid off. I knew I had the fitness to get through it. And that just gave me confidence to go out there and do what I did. And then I was really trying hard not to look at the scoreboard. but going into floor, I just knew I had to nail those landings because I didn't do in qualification. And I knew if I did that, then I should have been in the medals, and I was happy to be. So vault final, that was the only individual final I made. Going into it, I knew there was people that had bigger vaults than me, and I kind of have the advantage of having clean and tidy vaults. So I knew that if I just went and did them and landed them well, then I could be in the medals. And that was just my main focus, to land them and try and nail them. And I did, so I was obviously really happy with that. And it was my 10th senior medal as well. So if you like this video and want to keep up to date with new ones, please like and subscribe.